As you can see, our electrical setup sits right in there. It's behind the shower and only accessible by the back of the van. Okay, so I don't actually have that much room down here. I'm just lying behind the batteries and I'm going to run you through everything. So first off, powering the van, we have 200 amp hour Renogy lithium batteries. They are self-heating and they're connected in parallel to create 200 amp hours. Now to connect these batteries, we use 70 mil cable. It's very flexible, very high amperage, which is really made for battery usage. So we got self-heating batteries, as a lot of our time we spend in the European Alps and in the northern part of Norway and Sweden above the Arctic Circle, where it can get down to negative 30 very easily. So we wanted to be able to charge our batteries when it's cold, and these were really the perfect product for us. They're not essential for everyone, but for us spending a lot of time in cold areas, it was a must have. So to charge these batteries, we have three ways of doing it. A 40 amp Renogy MPPT charger, a 40 amp DC to DC charger made by Renogy as well, and a 30 amp mains hookup charger, which is made by Victron Energy. So first off, I'll run you through our solar system that we have right now. On the roof, we have two 175 watt flexible panels made by Renogy. We had one on our previous van and it worked fantastic, so we opted to go for two this time. So that runs down the wall in 10 millimeter cable, special solar cable with extra protection, and that goes to our 40 amp MPPT charger. And you might be wondering why we need such a big charger for only two panels at 300 watts in total. Well, the reason is flexibility, really. We wanted to be able to add more panels if we want to, and then on top of that, if we have portable panels that we just want to plug in if we're stuck somewhere for a while, we wanted to have that option. So we got the bigger charger, and hopefully that's able to cope with all our add-ons that we do in the future. So out of the MPPT charger, the cable runs down to our DC circuit breaker. That's in 10 millimeters, and then from there it goes to the battery or to the negative bus bar. So I did make a little mistake in our solar system, our charging process. Make sure you stick around to the end of the video, as I said, and I'll tell you what it is. So our second way of charging is the 40 amp DC to DC charger, also by Renogy. This will help keep the batteries topped up as we drive around, and this is really our key way to charge the batteries very quickly. It's our strongest source apart from the mains power. So for this one, we ran 16 mil all the way to the front of the van, which is what Renogy recommends. We then used a 60 amp fuse at the front of the van near the battery there where it connects, and then that runs into our DC charger back here, where we've also run out 16 mil to a 50 amp fuse and then to our batteries. So to turn on our charger, we just turn on the key to the ignition. As the car gets ignition, this receives power from a D plus cable. The D plus cable runs from the back of the van on the passenger side tail light. There used to be an old cigarette port there, and I've removed it since, but I use one of the positive cables that only turns on when the ignition is turned on. So our third way of charging is a 30 amp Victron Energy charger. I opted to go for the Victron Energy charger, not the Renogy, as the Renogy one didn't seem to be as good. So out of the Victron charger, I had some 16 mil left over that I used for the DC to DC charger, so I just included that all the way down to its own circuit breaker and protection, and then onto the batteries. So the thing I do like about the Victron Energy charger is it comes with its own app, and it's really easy to use. If you have to change parameters, as we did with the Renogy batteries, we changed the voltage and made our own preset, which is called Renogy batteries. So the reason we got a mains power charger is because there are times when you might be stuck somewhere, it's winter or whatever the reason is, and you just need to plug in to charge your batteries, as there's no sun, you don't plan on moving anytime soon, so the easiest way to charge is naturally to plug into power. So behind us, we also have a 2000 watt inverter. This just allows us to use our household appliances. The thing I liked about this 2000 watt inverter is that it automatically senses when voltage is coming in from the outside, and it'll switch over automatically. So in our old van, in the inverter, it didn't have that, and one day I accidentally left the other inverter on and I blew up the inverter. My mistake. But this one has an automatic switch. Every time you plug in, it senses voltage from the outside and flicks it over and turns the inverter off and uses main power. So you're probably wondering why we didn't go for the 2000 watt inverter and charger all in one. Well, it's really simple for me. It was the weight and the size of the charger and inverter. As you can see behind me, we've got the inverter there and the charger just there, and they're really small, they're lightweight. It did cost a little bit extra, but I would rather that than have a big 20 kilo unit in here. Our inverter weighs about 2 kilos and the charger is not even a kilo. So our inverter actually has a lot of the same functions that the other one does, such as auto switch over, all the protection it has, it's all the same. It just doesn't have that charger built into it. So for the cables for the inverter, we used 70 mil cables, the same as the mains. It runs through its own 200 amp circuit breaker, which is DC, of course. It's a pretty simple inverter. It has a remote as well. So up in the kitchen area, if we want to turn the inverter on, we just flip the remote. It'll turn it on and turn it off. On standby, we notice it uses about 1 amp of power. So if we're not using it, we just turn it off. So a big question we always get is, how do you monitor your system? So to monitor our system, we wanted to keep everything really simple. We wanted everything in one place, from temperature, tanks, battery levels, all on one screen. So we opted for the Simmarine Pico, I think it's called the standard model, which comes with two shunts. So it has a shunt to monitor your battery usage and how much you're going through or charging, and a tank shunt, which we connect our tank probes and temperature levels to. So we added two resistive tank probes, one for the fresh water, one for the gray water, and then three temperature resistive elements. One goes outside, one's for the battery area, and one's for in the main cab. So with our Simmarine system, we set alarms. So every time the gray water gets high or the fresh water gets low, an alarm will go off and tell us that we need to fill up or we need to empty. Also with the batteries, it'll tell you when you're fully charged, how long you have left till it's gonna be fully discharged. Are you charging at the moment? Are you discharging? And then you can add on other shunts where it can monitor how much energy a certain appliance is using. So it can go through and monitor how much your diesel heater is using, how much your refrigerator is using. It's not really the most comfortable. So I did tell you guys that I would show you what we did wrong, and I'll run through it now. So our two lithium batteries can only charge 50 amps continuous current, but our DC to DC charger uses 40 amp and our solar has the potential to use 40 amp as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a normally closed automotive relay. This is going to be switched on when the ignition comes on from the same port as the Renogy DC to DC charger, that D plus. It's going to activate at the same time. This is going to open the circuit, which will disconnect the solar panels from the solar and ultimately disconnect charging to our batteries. So there is another option we could have got here. We could have gotten the DC to DC charger and the MPPT charger all in one as Renogy sells. Originally I didn't want that because it limits your charging current to 25 amps, and I wanted to be able to have 40 amps of charging current just in case we have to charge our batteries as quick as possible. So number two is probably should have gotten smart batteries, which has the Bluetooth connection so you can connect to your batteries and see everything that's going on. With Renogy, you can buy the little module that you plug into the network port on top of the batteries and the solar, but I think having the Bluetooth option where it's already in, all ready to go and set up and everything would have been a smarter option. But I think definitely next time we would probably opt for the Renogy smart batteries. So the final thing is obviously the capacity of the batteries. We're pretty sure that 200 amp hour is going to be enough for us, but there is going to be times, I'm sure of it, where we're going to want a little bit more juice, especially when we're editing videos or photos or whatever. But for now we've got 200 amp hours, we're going to see how that goes, and if in the future we need to get more, then we'll get more. So the last thing we would change is probably something on the Simmarine Pico. You can actually get a shunt where it monitors each individual appliance and how much you're using. I think this would be pretty handy because if you are using things that you don't really need to use all the time, it can tell you where you're sort of drawing more power, and you could limit using those appliances to save power, especially in winter when we don't get solar and driving all the time sort of thing. So I think that would be really handy. Hey guys, if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps our channel grow, and subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you next time.